It takes about 30 seconds. I'll tell you when it starts. It's going to be about at least an hour.
People around the world, we're here for sorrow.
Thank you. silly ways. Or throw them out the window, the wisdom of your ways. I've been there and I know lots of other ways. What a jolly bad shot if all you ever do is. Good. Streaming works.
Business you don't like. Sex and drugs and rock and roll. Sex and drugs and rock and roll. Sex and drugs and rock and roll is very good indeed. Every bit of clothing ought to make you pretty. You can cut the clothing, grey is such a pity. I should wear the clothing of Mr. Walter Mitty. See my tailor, he's called Simon. I know it's going to fit. You're quite welcome, it is free. Don't do nothing that is cut, cause you know what they'll make you be. They will try their tricky device, trap you with the ordinary. Get your teeth into a small slice, the cake of liberty. Sex and drugs and rock and roll. Sex and drugs and rock and roll. Sex and drugs and rock and roll. Sex and drugs and rock and roll.
on the wall somewhere around them, I could probably say that was sorrow.
I could get it sorrow, yeah, but it's such a bit strange.
Look at the flower around the square.
I've got no idea.
Yeah.
you can take your off, ladies, or...
I want to try.
No.
This is not for children. There's no hope of a good stuff, please. Because it's very delicate. It's very, very delicate. You want to do a 1-2-1-2? One, two, one, two?
Oh, I don't know. What's he doing down here?
I'm going to put it down for the little people. No, but, hang on.
Oh, hi.
Hang on.
Is this a warmer pack?
Come on. Give me a sec, yeah? I ain't got on yet.
Hello.
Hi. Hello.
1-2-1-2. Bruno Doss. I can remember.
Sorrow.
Happy? I'm ever so happy.
You're okay.
This is fine.
sorry.
Hello, hello, everybody, please gather around. Let's come and gather around here at the tent. If people would like to take some seats, come on down. Come on, everybody, show's about to begin.
Have a chair.
Alan, come and sit here. Come and sit next to us. Sit next to us.
When they had to do in Spain, with a very heavy frame. So I didn't bring the frame, I had it framed.
Such a shy crowd all of a sudden.
Thank you.
We need all the bendy ones at the front.
Yeah, all the acrobats.
Come on.
Or ex-acrobats. Hello, hello. Welcome, everybody. Dearly beloved brothers and sisters, friends and family, we're here to celebrate and bid farewell to our friend, the lovely Sorrel. Yes. But, yes, an emphasis on celebrate. Sorrel would appreciate that. Sorrel would channeling through the dogs now. Badger, that's it. But an emphasis on celebration for someone like Sorrel, who would want to know the way, and who brought such celebration with her everywhere she went. And it's beautiful to be gathering here on Abby and Enzo and Will's land, where Sorrel spent so many good times, to know that she'll be she'll be here for some good times to come as well. Isn't that a beautiful thing? Without too much further ado, it's very beautiful to see so many people come to pay their respects. What a woman, what a legend. And she was always a friendly face to bump into. Yeah. Quite often around the fire with a recording in the early hours was where I bumped into her. Most often, and and it's always a good time, a good thing. So I'm going to ask my friend Enzo to step up and read the eulogy now. Want to come on over?
Yeah. Oh, hi everyone.
Hi.
This is Sorrel's eulogy. You please pardon my accent sometimes. So I hope you understand. The memorial of Joanna Sandland, a.k.a. Sorrel Badger, a.k.a. DJ Sosmix, and a.k.a. Sos, 16 of July 1961, 10th of February 2024. She was an independent spirit. We're here today to honor an extraordinary woman. to acknowledge our loss, to connect with each other, and to reflect upon our life. You are all welcome here today, especially Sorrel's mother Gillian and her chosen daughter Ramona Berryman, aka Maui. Sorrel would have been chuffed to see you all here and know how much you all cared. Sorrel went out of her way to maintain friendship and stay in touch with people. Sorrel life story. So the early years, Sorrel was born in Queen Charlotte's Hospital, Hammersmith, on the 16th July 1961, and was brought up in Isleworth. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Ida. Thank you for your help. Isleworth, Middlesex. Sorrel was an only child, as were both of her parents. Her father had been an actor, and his mother before him had owned a theatre in Staffordshire. Her mother said she was a lovely baby and a pretty child. She was very good and sweet right up until started school. Sorrel passed the 11 plus and got into the local grammar school. Her mum said she was always bright and didn't have to work hard. Sorrel was heartbroken when her father died when she was just 12 years old. She went to Board and one of the oldest girls' school in England, the Royal Masonic School for Girls in Reckmansworth, which turned out to be nothing like St. Trinian's. She hated it and couldn't wait to leave once she was 16. Sorrel came back to live at home with her mum and studied graphic design at West Thames College in Isleworth. An 18th century grade two listed building which once belonged to Joseph Banks. Later she worked in a graphic design studio. She also had a job illustrating booklets for Derbyshire Council. She was an excellent old school freehand sign writer. She loved to travel and was always adventuring off somewhere. In the early 80s, Sorrel became an actor in an amateur theater company in Wistful called the Lindley Players. After Canterbury Art College, she worked at Canterbury Heritage Center. In 1983, Sorrel led a course at the Women Carpentry Workshop in Bristol, which later led her to work as a carpenter in Amsterdam. She lived in Tipi Valley in Wales for about a year. In 1983, she joined the Greenham Women. Sorrel's longtime good friend Naomi Ocean has a distinct memory of her naked at Green Gate, sewing banners together to wrap around the base. She would have been 20 years old then. She was a regular at Stonehenge Solstice Festival and became known as Sorrel when she was 25. The people she cared about. In 1987, when Sorrel was around 26 years old, she got together with Nick Pedler. They were the loss of each other lives. They lived in a cheap little two-up, two-down stone house, 8 miles from the nearest town near Stalyto in Powys, Mid Wales. They had a veg garden, but no electricity or running water. The rent was £1 a week. She became the unofficial guardian of two young children of her longtime good friend, Beryl Smith, in Wales. Bethan and Gemma, who are now both in their mid and late 30s. Beryl and Sorrel were cut from the same cloth, as were many of her female friends. Sorrel was also a very ungodly mother to Tom Dowd, the son of another longtime good friend, Sue Dowd, in Bristol. Alas, Tom Dowd has recently died. May he rest in peace. Eventually, Nick and Sorrel parted company, and Sorrel took her broken heart to make her home in France, living in a vehicle with her dog. Sorrel became part of a small alternative community near Carcassonne, an area steeped in mysticism with loads of hippies. There were good times, and she was even thinking of buying land there, but in 1997, she came down to visit El Morion with Long John and found her tribe. Sadly, Nick Peddle died of a brain tumor in 2000 at the age of 33. Sorrel met her friend Hamish Berryman and his daughter Ramona when Ramona was about 5 years old, and they remained close even when Ramona went to live in the UK. In early 2003, Sorrel bought her house in Lancaron and built it up over the years, adding onto it with her builder and DJ friend Alex Brigham. She created a carpentry workshop, swimming pool and beautiful garden. She shared her home with many animals and the odd human, including Luke and Doris' dog. She loved El Pueblo, Lancaron. Music. Sorrel was known as a dance DJ going by the name of Sosmix. She played brilliant back-to-back DJ sets with Loza Love, aka Lauren Clark. Sorrel was a regular guest musician with the Seven Kevins from Valles, Malaga, where she met one of her closest musical friends, Maxim Benton. Since 2011, Sorrel has performed in the duo Las Favoritas, playing quirky cowgirl songs with her own accordion and Fi Primarolo ukulele. Sam Meaden said that Sorrel loved performing and would play her music at countless benefits awareness raising nights and festivals, including the Convoy Cabaret Festival and Lancaron Carnival. Interests. Sorrel began her scuba diver training in Egypt in 2009, and over time she did a lot of specialist courses. She ended up being qualified as a master scuba diver, the highest non-professional qualification. Leonie said she really never did anything by heart. Sorrel successfully finished her sailing course in Gibraltar, obtaining her Royal Yachting Association Certificate of Competence. Activism. She volunteered as a crew member on the Sea Shepherd, whose sole mission is to protect and conserve the world's ocean and marine lives. She was in Sardinia helping to stop the illegal tuna fishing in the Mediterranean. She volunteered collecting research data for the International Center for Environmental Monitoring, a foundation concerned with climate change. They were studying the loss of marine biodiversity back in July 2016. Sorrel first volunteered for the Refugee Community Kitchen in 2016 when the Calais jungle was there. She volunteered maybe 3 or 4 times and regularly delivered olive oil from and Spanish produce. Refugee Community Kitchen is Sorrel's chosen charity, so please consider make a donation on her behalf. That's some of what was Sorrel's story. Obviously what we could collect, and there was a lot more.
Yeah, my friend Leo spoke to me on the phone, the fiddle player Leo Hess, and couldn't come today, but he was like, "Ah, Sorrel, she was like the mum and the mate of us all, you know," which I thought was very apt.
Yeah.
I'm going to ask Imogen to come up, and she's got a poem to read to you now, presuming she's out there somewhere. Maybe she's not. Oh, I love it. Imogen? Imagine.
Imagine a
Definitely says Imogen on the running order, Abby. Alright, I'll has anyone seen Imogen? Can anyone? Imogen? No? Well, I'm going to read my poem. I'll be Imogen.
I'm Imogen.
You are Imogen.
I'm Imogen.
So how did anyone call? Has any of the Imogens got a poem? No? Well, I have.
I've got a poem.
I bet you have. I'm going to read my poem now, so that Imogen's not here. Or maybe she is, she's just shy. Maybe. I'm going to put my glasses on so I can see the words. You know, don't worry, talk amongst yourselves. Sorrel would have loved it this way. Fumbling at the microphone, finally, Doug. High queen of the stormy mountain, wayward daughter of the sun, empress of the open road, and bringer of the fun. Warm heart in winter's brooding, wise words for every ear. Now lost to us, flown far away, but held forever near. Burning colours in the darkness, bringing laughter to the dawn. Making music for sweet reveries, to carry us onwards to the morn. Dressed up in her glad rags, looking as ever at her best. Ready to rock on down the road, and blaze a trail for all the rest. So farewell, sister, lover, mother of this crazy scene. Thanks for all the songs and cheer and all the fun that it has been. Ride on across the heavens, blazing like a distant star. I'll see you at the after party for a drink at the Cosmic Bar. That I will as well. Yeah, you're just like a star waiting to be born. I know the feeling. Maybe your time hasn't come to shine yet. I don't know. I mean, I'll give her the mic unless someone stops me. Well, look, there's a song to go now from this dog.
Here's my poem. Ruff, 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 ruff.
So, could we have Amy and Akasha? Is that a song?
Akasha, that's you.
And Jess, Amy and Akasha and Jess. Can't believe this running order's so shabby, Abby.
Sorry.
All right, a little welcome.
We'll talk about it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't mind.
Sometimes I mean I have to get out.
Oh, yeah, we need the thingy. Hold on, I'm gonna hear it. You need it to say the words.
Hi, so this is a tune that me and Star learned years ago, and then Amy subsequently wrote some words for it. We've got a perfect shouty.
Can I just say what actually happened, though?
Because Akasha was playing the thingy at like Boomtown or something, and then Sorrel just went, I have to learn that tune! And she went off to go and get her accordion, and it was miles away, it took ages, and Akasha had to wait there. She came all the way back with her accordion because she was so keen to learn this tune. And then sometime later the words appeared, but they weren't.
Yeah, that's a much better telling of the story.
If a little bit more burbly.
I don't want to put my ass in Sorrel's face.
Oh,
so
she would love it.
She would love it.
So we don't want to get in there. We don't really want to. Okay. The instruments of time, my ball and chain, my ball and chain. The instruments of time, my ball and chain.
Not stuck in a hole, the tears down the shade. Not stuck in.
stuck in a moment, in a self-cliché. Not stuck in a moment, in a self-cliché. But rolling, 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 moving on.
Now it's time for someone who loves to be on stage. Now it's for someone who's purposely made their career not being on stage, but making sure that everything on stage works really well. So Abby's going to say a few words. So welcome Abby to the stage, please.
Thank you. Thanks, Dad. Just wanted to say a few words about Sorrel. I'm going to try and hold it down. Sorrel was my fiercest friend, in all senses of the word. She was loyal, generous and protective, and she ranted and she told us all off. My story about Sorrel is, when my son Will was 1 year old, we were living in the south of Spain all together. Will had a heart condition and he needed to go to Toulouse for a doctor's appointment, and Sorrel offered to drive me there, just for the weekend. She had some business to attend to, so it wasn't entirely selfless. When we were at the doctor's, I was told that Will needed a heart operation and it was going to be scheduled for the following week. I wasn't expecting that and I was in a total state. How would I get back to Spain afterwards with a fragile child? And Sorrel didn't pause for a second. She says, I'll come back and pick you up. And she did. It was a 2,600-kilometre round trip. And I still owe her for that act of friendship. Sorrel sang like a nightingale. Trevor once said, she has the perfect voice, doesn't she? And she bellowed like a dragon, calling out bullshit and injustice. She was brave and she was vulnerable. She was sometimes lonely, but she was never self-pitying. She found companionship in her community. As Bates said, we've lost an elder. I miss her singing and her swearing and her toothy grin and her dirty laugh. Miranda has made some postcards with some classic Sorrel quotes on the back, so please feel free to take one. And Becky Moon, there's also a book for you to add a message or a photograph if you'd like to. And Becky Moon has made some willow hearts. There are only a few, but if you'd like to, please take one to plant at your place to remember Sorrel. Not that we can ever forget.
And Amy's going to come up and do a poem by Mary, is that right?
Oh, yeah, that's me.
That's you, back for more. Right.
Thanks for your beautiful story, Abby, that's really lovely. Here's a poem by somebody called Mary, who I don't know, but she can't be here today, but she really wanted this poem to be read. It's called The Mountains. Another mountain fell today, no one suspected a thing. A gap in the landscape, devastation, the dust of tears and bewilderment. No one saw it coming. What has happened to the mountains? So many proud and lofty peaks have tumbled. The cream of Bohemia, they who inspired, who led, who left a trail of joy and fire. Where are they now? The jugglers, the poets, musicians, the wizards, the gypsy souls, the anarchists of love who blaze like comets across a savage sky. Where is Nick and Daniel and Tina and Jake, Nige and Andy? Where are they now? No one knows. And the landscape has changed forever. And now, dear Sorrel, dear feisty and fiery Sorrel, who sang and played and made the world a better place. Has she joined the parade to the big top in the sky? I would like to believe. The mountains are falling into the sea, and I am bereft.
Amazing words. Mary Guyver, that was right. Angela, would you like to say a bit more poetry? I think Sorrel would approve. Oh, here you go.
I was thinking about how it is when people who we love so dearly are not physically with us, and how it's possible to continue that friendship and that relationship. And I feel that it's sometimes possible by being open to those moments of communication that could happen. I kind of learned this through my dad passed away about 5 years ago, but I continued to have a relationship with him through just being open to moments of him. And there's this lovely poem that I came across and thought I'd read it to you. It's by Mary Oliver, who you might know. And I didn't bring my glasses, so that's rubbish. And that'd be perfect. Filthy. I've changed a couple of words because this is now for a different auntie. Sorry, Mary Oliver, I've slightly bastardised your poem, but not too much. Auntie Leaf. Needing one, I invented her. The great, great aunt, dark as chicory, called Shining Leaf, or Drifting Cloud, or Beauty of the Night. Dear aunt, I'd call up into the leaves and she'd rise up like an old log in a pool and whisper in a language only the two of us knew, the word that meant follow. And we'd travel, cheerful as birds, out to the dusty town and into the trees, where she would change both of us into something quicker. Two foxes with black feet, two snakes green as ribbons, two shimmering fish, and all day we'd travel. At day's end, she'd leave me at my own back door, with the rest of my family, who were kind, but solid as wood, and rarely wandered. While she, old twist of feathers and birch bark, could walk in circles wide as rain and then float back, scattering the rags of twilight on fluttering moth wings. Or she'd slouch from the hedge like an old grey badger. Or she'd hang in the milky moonlight like a burning medallion. This bone dream, this friend I had to have, this old woman made out of leaves.
Yeah, there's something about that, those experiences, I suppose, and accordion wielding women like Sorrel, and men as well, but yeah, mostly women. So those people you meet in the midnight cabaret or round some campfire somewhere, do you know what I mean, that play those songs to you, and that sort of stays with you. So despite hosting this farewell for Sorrel here, and knowing that I won't bump into her around the campfire, I sort of will always be bumping into her around the campfire, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that'll definitely stay with me, and no doubt haunt me if there's anything to do with Sorrel. has anyone got anything else, anyone got any words they'd like to share? There's an opportunity to do that now, on this microphone.
I loved Sorrel to bits. She was fucking awesome. Met her in 93 in a lay-by, I Was Broken Down, and she saw Travs at the roadside and drops in to say hello. A few years later, there we were all down in El Morio. And she's not alone. There's so many people in my life who've come and gone. I see them or I don't see them. But what I want to say here is that when we've had a friend like that, they ain't gone, because they live on in all our memories. They're still here. We don't let go of them. We hang on to them. And we keep them alive. It'll be the same for us when we go. Those who know us will remember us. And we'll not be gone until all our friends and tribe are gone as well. That's it. We were blessed. Any more? Roll up. Anyone got a roll up?
No.
Good. Because I'd quit. No one smokes anymore because it's so uncool. Yeah, back in our day, you know, all that rock and roll suicide was so cool, thanks to David Bowie. Well,
took his time over it.
He did, yeah. He looked good when he smoked as well, didn't he? Oh, you'd like to come up and say some words? Fantastic. Please. Take this microphone off of me.
I just wanted to say that I don't know a lot of you, and I think that's a real testament to Sorrel, because she had so many families and she had so many threads into so many hearts. And I really love that, because actually I knew her in Bristol, I knew her in Nick, I was with Nick when he just probably died. And she stayed in touch, you know, and we kept that going. And I think that's a real testament to somebody who shares love, also shouts, rants, swears, does roll-ups, couple of pipes in the living room, whatever. You know, Sorrel cut us way through all of our lives. And I just love the fact that I don't know many of you, and I'm hoping to get conversations with you today, because it's because of that she brought us all together. A strange gift in death. And I want to thank Sorrel for that.
Any more? It's going to be like a sort of open mic situation, I can tell you. Last chance. Well, probably not last chance, actually. You can probably storm the microphone at any point during the rest of the evening and be able to chat at the bar as well. Come on now. So be it, Sorrel's never-ending poetry memory cabaret begins.
So me and Sorrel travelled around a bit with my kids and stuff, and in the van and around France and things, and we'd go busking together. We'd go around the west coast and bus the terraces and everything. And one day we ended up in Lourdes, where all the Catholics go, and they got there all praying everywhere and everything. And we were on the bridge where everybody's walking past to go and do all their prayers, and there's thousands of them there. And there were all these shops with all these like little plastic Jesuses everywhere, and we just couldn't resist it. We looked at each other and we just like, let's play plastic Jesus. So we sat on the bridge and we were pissing ourselves laughing, playing plastic Jesus on the bridge. And then it got to a point where she was just like, her conscience couldn't do it. I'm really bad, but her conscience was just like, I think we've done enough now. But it was such a good giggle. I love her to bits. We had so many good times together, and she was a wise old soul. She always looked after, she really looked, kept an eye on my kids, you know, and bless her, she was amazing. And I have had a couple of winks from her since she's left. She came down and had a little chat with me the other day, a couple of weeks ago. She was like, Harry, I'm doing this festival upstairs, and I need some musicians. She's going, can you help me out? And I go, well, look, Sorrel, everyone down here is still alive. You need to ask somebody else. And I said, hang on a minute. And I just kind of tuned in for a minute. I was like, oh, wait a minute, here we go, pop one up. And there was somebody on another planet just ascending at that moment, who was some master musician. So I pointed her in the right direction. She just was gone straight away. She was like, thank you, see you later. And so, she's on form, and she's having a good time. Yeah, so I wasn't going to say anything, but she prodded me, so okay.
Unlike Sorrel, not to prod anyone else at this point. All right, well, we now have got, we've got Sorrel with us, haven't we? We're gonna have a little bit of a tree planting ceremony with Sorrel. You're going like that, but which Becky Moon is going to lead, I believe. Yes. Well, I'm Andy, Becky Moon.
Yeah.
Hello. Yes.
Hello. This is
I can't do it up.
I'm just going to have to do the usual one. Unaccustomed, as I am, to public speaking, which I bloody am. I've never done this before. It's the first time I've ever held a mic. I've been fretting somewhat. And I woke up in the middle of the night thinking about, actually, this Willow Arch. And Sorrel, obviously. Now, this is where she stood, where the other little heart is over there, to celebrate Abby and Enzo's wedding. A couple of years ago. And I woke up in the middle of the night with the word arch in my mind. And I was thinking about the significance of it, which followed with a 4 a.m. internet search, which produced these rather apt dictionary definitions of both the word arch and our dear souls. And I'm just going to actually read these with some screenshots that I did. So, arch, marked by a deliberate and often forced playfulness, irony or impudence, as in known for her arch comments. Greater or especially worse than others of the same type, as in she's always been an arch opponent of injustice and bullshit. Showing that you think it is amusing that you know more about something than someone else does. Using an arch tone of voice. And finally, mischievous, saucy and clever. That's ourselves. And we have another little willow arch here to plant in this carefully prepared hole. Abby, are you going to come and know? Are you going to get up? Oh, that's a good idea.
You can take Sorrel as well.
Okay, so now we're going to give Sorrel a swim as well. Now she loves that. So you're going to put her in the river here so that she'll get carried off down to the sea. And Matt's going to lead that with Angela now. Do you want to come and gather around?
Thank you.
clean away, but I just cannot stay. I'll sink in my swimming pool.
Playing something.
Woo-hoo!
Sorry to be sharp.
No, exactly.
I don't know if you could hear that. Maxine wrote this song, and she.
So we're going to do a song that we used to do in our band with Sorrel back in the day, if we can remember it. When we used to play with Sorrel, she always used to go, "You're going too fast! Slow down! You're going too fast! Slow down!" So we're going to go too fast and slow down. All right.
Do you want to go on the stage so we can get you on the right feet?
Okay.
Light.
Yeah, light and everything.
Glass.
Everything.
Right,
okay. Okay.
Okay. You have to say something.
So this is for Sorrel. We'll be with you in a minute.
Official proceedings to an end. Now it's time for the unofficial proceedings to unfold.
I lost my seat.
It's been beautiful to see so many people come together to celebrate Sorrel today, and as someone said, so from so many different paths and places, she touched so many lives. And I was lightening the mood earlier when I arrived. With a bit of a comedy line, which I didn't know whether we should drop on the microphone or not, whether it's appropriate in this sort of occasion.
Do it anyway.
We decided it was probably not, and we should probably do it anyway.
Yes.
And, one thing I can be sure of, above all else, is that Sorrel would have wanted us to put the fun back in funeral. So remember, it's as much a celebration as a farewell, and we'll be seeing her soon enough down the road, and she'll be here with us at all the parties and events and tears and joys that are going to pass here on this land, and long into the endless night when we sit around the cosmic campfire listening to the rambling tales of clowns like us into eternity. So, yeah. No change there. If anything, she's got off lightly. So let's hear it for Sorrel one more time. Andrea helped us also through the buffet. It'll be opening now. And there'll be music and canoodling and dancing and chatting in the bar. Feel free to hang out, let yourself go, share stories of Sorrel. jaw on drunkenly later to people that don't really want to listen or do. All the things that Sorrel loved about us, there's no time for that to shine through. And know that she'll be there. The last gig I did with her actually was a wedding in the south of France. And she was there all fussing, setting up with all the recording, all the bits and pieces and stuff. And then it's like, she had a microphone. She had all the microphones actually. And so I needed to do the ceremony. And I was like, oh, Sorrel, can I just borrow the mic? And she was like, like, it's only for the ceremony, sorry. All right then, just make sure you bring it back. But yeah, one more time for Sorrel. Thanks so much. Yay!
Quick, put some music on.
I got one more tune.
Go on then.
One more tune.
One more tune.
She liked this one. It's about a woman who drinks. It's about people who drink too much.
Did we get on the live
stream? No. Can we finish? Alright, one more thing. I've got to find the C first. Right. One more tune for Sorrel. Right. Where's the C?
One more tune for Sorrel.
There it is.
Yeah, it's all the tension. Yeah, it's all the tension.
Sorry.
Well, yeah, I mean, when it's end times, that's what it is.
It's a kicking out. Well, that's a great time to play. Oh, it's good.
It's different types.
Psychotherapy.
Switch it off. You're a deputy dog, because it's not very dark tonight.
Thank you. Is that good? Right. No, is it good?